In this video, you're going to learn the exact steps you need to take in order to make your presentation slides look great without any graphic design experience. These are the 5 exact steps I run people through whenever they ask me for slide design help. And they work regardless of what industry you're in or what type of presentation you're building. They work whether you're using Microsoft PowerPoint, Google Slides, or Apple's Keynote. The reason these steps are great is that you don't need to have any graphic design experience or a good eye in order to apply them to your presentations. For example, you'll be able to build out slides that look like these in just a few minutes. By the end of this video, you'll also learn a secret trick for making everything on your slide look perfectly positioned in under a minute. Hi, I'm Camille, the co-founder of Nuts & Bolts Speech Training, and I'm excited you're here. Step 1, pare down your content. The very first step of great slide design is to pare down your content and refine your message. One of the biggest causes of death by PowerPoint is not only having too much on one slide, and even more than that, it's not having a clear, concise, and memorable point. Presentation design experts like David Phillips say that if you focus on more than one key message per slide, your slide will increase the time that it takes for people to see and digest information by 500%. So I urge you to spend some time thinking about the slide and what it needs to tell the audience in a simple and easy to grasp way. Think about what it is exactly that you want your slide to say, and how can you convey that in as few words as possible. If you can do that well, your slide will be successful. A great place to start is with your title. What do you want someone to know about your slide? Instead of saying market overview, say huge market opportunity for a luxury brand. That's ultimately what you're trying to tell people. Or instead of quarter four results, say quarter four results are up 30%. And notice how clarifying your message in the title changes what you need to present to back it up. Now, once you have your point and you've written out the content for your slide, what I recommend doing is trying to cull down your content even further. And you can do that in a number of ways. The first way is to simplify your sentences. So instead of writing all your content out in full sentences, turn it into short statements. The second way is to just remove things from your slide and perhaps putting them in your talking notes so you can still bring them up but don't need the audience to read them on the slide. On this slide, for example, there are way too many words. I will need to cull them down significantly so that the slide is actually readable. And the best way to do that is to go through each paragraph and pull out the key point and turn that into one sentence at most. Now, this may still be too much slot text, it may still be too crowded, but at least it's readable. If you stay with the slide, you do, however, run the risk of having your audience read the slide. And that's a big no-no because it lowers your credibility and puts the audience to sleep. So I would recommend taking it a step further and culling the text even more to just the key points like this. Now, you just have your highlights and you can elaborate more verbally. That way, you're demonstrating your knowledge and expertise, and you're also keeping the audience more engaged by having them listen to you rather than just read the slide. Now, sometimes we need to keep more text on the slide than we'd like. Maybe you can't just pare it down like this because the presentation needs to stand on its own without you there talking over it. So how do we work with content-heavy presentations? Well, the third way is to divide it up into multiple slides. Oftentimes, we feel like we have to put everything we want to say on one slide, but in reality, slides are free, so go ahead and use more than one. In this example, we could simply break up the slide into two slides, which gives us a lot more breathing room. And as we'll see later in the video, we'll also be able to add some visual elements to make the slide design better. Step 2, choose the framework. Once you have your content ready, it's time to start thinking about how it can best be displayed in terms of the layout, colors, fonts, etc. These elements represent the skeleton of the slide, and they're mission critical for any good PowerPoint slide design. The first thing I usually do here is to see if there's anything that's pre-built that I can simply reuse or be inspired by. For example, Microsoft Office provides a whole set of pre-built PowerPoint themes and templates that are easy to use and that look pretty decent. Scroll among the options to see if one is a good fit. If one of these fits, then go ahead and use it as it is. Boom, you're done. If not, then you have to start looking elsewhere. I personally like to go to places like SlideShare and Pinterest to get slide design inspiration. There, I look at how the content is laid out and what color and font combinations are being used. For example, I like the font combination of serif and sans serif, and I like here how bold and bright the colors are. I also like how minimalist the style is with the use of blocks of colors, so I'm going to use this as inspiration. And the next step is to take the elements that you like and apply them to your content. So for my example, I'm going to find a similar font pairing and color palette and end up bringing it in like this. Or with this Pinterest example, I might change the slide to look something more like this. If you're building a presentation that's just a one-time thing, then you can just edit your slide in the normal view as is. But if you're building a presentation that will be reused, and this represents most of the presentations out there, I highly recommend creating a theme and custom template. If you want to learn how to build a custom PowerPoint theme or template, check out my video here on screen. Step 3, make it visual. Now that you have the content, framework, fonts, and all the colors ready, the next step is to make it visual. We all know that PowerPoint is a visual medium, but oftentimes it feels like we have to be a graphic designer in order to know how to create great slides. But the truth is, you just need to be able to take your concepts and translate them from words to visuals, whether that means replacing the words with visuals or simply adding them in. You can do that by breaking up the text into chunks and by adding visual elements. Those can be pictures, graphical elements, icons, or simply shapes. For example, with my example from the previous step, I've simply added colored and outlined shapes around my text in a way that makes the overall slide more visual. I could go a step further and add icons to further enhance the message of each text block, or I could even find quality image to really make this visual like this. Here's some other examples of how to take a slide that's text only and make it more visual. Now, one extra tip here is to use images that are as real as possible. Clip art and graphics like these are outdated and ineffective. Use images that are more realistic like these. Step 4, lay it out. This step is not just about making sure your slide is laid out in a pleasing way, but it's also about giving the audience's brains a break. That's right, as a presentation designer, whether you're a pro or not, your job is to give the viewer the path of least resistance for grasping your content. And that means making their lives easier. And one of the super simple yet effective ways to do this is to include lots of white space on your slide. And what do I mean? Well, take a look at these two slides. Does one seem easier to look at to you? The difference is all in the amount of empty space that is left around the content. And the same is true for this example. Now, to create white space, all you have to do is chunk up your content into blocks and bring them closer. If this is too hard with the amount of content you have, I would consider going through step number one again in order to pare it down and split the slide into so that you can have more space to work with. You may have to also shrink down the size of the text and the images on your slide. Step 5, align and position. The final step you should take to make sure your PowerPoint slide design is polished and professional looking is to align and position everything well. Nothing screams amateur more than jumping titles, shifting logos, and mismatched layout. Look at these slides, for example. If we go between these two slides, we notice that the layout moves, the title, the content, the chart moved. If I go to the next slide, it's shifting again. The next slide, it looks like the main content has moved. And in the next slide, it looks like things aren't really aligned here. It's uneven. It's not exactly perfect. Now, this is all fixable, and there are several ways to make sure that everything is aligned and positioned properly on your slide. And the first one is to hit the reset button so that PowerPoint can automatically move everything that's in a placeholder back into place. And let me show you how that works. Select all of the slides and hit the reset button. You'll notice that things have shifted in here. So the title and content were reset into the correct position and formatting. They're no longer bolded and they're in the right place. The chart has also been adjusted correctly. However, the logo here has actually not moved at all. So we're going to need to fix that in a different way. And the rest of this looks like this has not moved either. We're going to need to fix that. And for this slide, nothing has changed either. So let's go and address the first part, which is the jumping logo. If I actually select the logo, you'll notice that it's actually here on the normal view. So the logo is in each one of these slides, which is why they're not always in the exact same position because they're not a placeholder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to Control C to copy this, and I'm going to go into the Slide Master view, and I'm actually going to paste the logo here on the parent slide so that it appears everywhere in the correct position. Now you'll notice this one is slightly different because it is on a title slide and we have high background graphics selected, which is why everything on this slide is a little bit different. But if you notice all the rest of them, and other than the divider slide, they are all here positioned correctly. And this means that when we close out of the slide master view, we can jump around and notice that they're there. Now we're gonna have to delete all of these. Go down to the next slide, delete, 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 and this one is all set. So now if we go from slide to slide, you'll notice that the placeholders of the logos are all in the correct place. Now, the next step we have to do is to fix this second slide of the four-part sequence. And you'll notice that we're jumping around here. And the way to do this in the normal view, if you're not using anything that's affected in the slide master, because you'll notice here there is no placeholders, it's only a placeholder for a title, so these are all elements that were added in the normal view, we're gonna need to use the alignment tool. Now, first, let me make sure that we actually group everything first, because we are gonna want to make sure that all of these elements together are aligned to the center of the slide. So I'm gonna hit Control G to group this element, and then I'm going to go to the Drawing Tools Format tab, and then I'm gonna select Align, Align Center, so that the content jumps exactly to the middle of the slide, and you'll notice now they are matching perfectly. I'm gonna ungroup this, Control Shift G to ungroup, so that they're back to their individual shapes. Now, alignment doesn't just allow you to align things to a slide, you can also align things within or amongst each other. So, for example, here, we're gonna align this to the center of this shape. So, we select both together, align, align center. Now, the shoe, which is the smaller object, jumps to the middle of the center of the bigger object. We wanna actually make sure that these are all aligned to the center as well, because it looks like they're not exactly even. So, I'm gonna select all of these by using the Shift key and selecting all the items, align and align center as well. Now, the last step we have to do is to make sure that the space between each of these elements is even. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna group each one of these, Control G, Control G, Control G, and now these elements are their own individual pieces. And what we can do is select all three. You'll notice the space here is not even. We're gonna go to the Align tool, and this time we're going to select Distribute Horizontally. What this is going to do is it's going to place all the elements evenly between the furthest right point and the furthest left point on a horizontal axis. So if I select Distribute Horizontally, you'll notice the middle one jumps into the middle, and now they are all even. Now it does seem like the entire graphic is not centered on the slide, so if we group this again, Alt Center, Align Center, Control Shift G to ungroup, Control Shift G to ungroup, and now this is spread evenly across the slide. Now the last thing we have here, it appears that these three are not aligned, so I'm gonna select them all three, align top, to align them to the top. Using the alignment tool is critical because it not only takes out the guesswork and makes things 100% perfect, but it also saves you a ton of time. If you want to learn more about how to use the alignment tool like a master and save even more time, check out our video on fast-tracking object alignments on screen now. And those were the 5 easy steps for great PowerPoint slide design for beginners. If you found this video helpful, then make sure to subscribe to our channel to get the latest presentation and PowerPoint tips. You can also learn more about how to become a true PowerPoint master by visiting our website at nutsandboltsspeedtraining.com. Now, I want to turn it over to you. Which of the steps from this video do you typically overlook or avoid? Let me know by leaving a quick comment right below this video. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your presentation.